morning, church.
I have a couple of scriptures today to read. First is Psalm 98:4-9. Shout joyfully to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth in song. Rejoice and sing praises. Sing to the Lord with the harp and sound of a psalm. With trumpets and the sound of a horn, shout joyfully before the Lord the King. Let the sea roar and all its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it. Let the rivers clap their hands. Let the hills be joyful together before the Lord. For he is coming to judge the earth. With righteousness he shall judge the world and the people with equity. Our second verse is Luke 2, verse 10. And that is, then the angel said to them, do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. And the church says,
amen.
Amen.
We'll have a reading by Rachel Botros and Luke Humphrey. They're portraying Mary and Joseph in dueling type monologues, coming to grips with major events in their lives. Let us listen as they share their thoughts.
An angel.
It was an angel.
I've always heard about them.
One reads about them in Scripture.
But you never expect it to happen to you.
They always appear to the righteous.
Angels always seem to herald major catastrophic events.
The holy.
Earthquakes.
Prophets.
Plagues.
Great leaders.
Kingdoms falling.
The chosen. So why me?
Why me?
I don't have some great lineage or grand destiny. I'm just a teenage girl.
I'm nothing but a carpenter. I'm not even married yet.
It was like a dream.
It appeared to me in a dream.
I looked up and there it was.
Dead asleep I was.
Standing right in the doorway.
I was dreaming something about carpentry.
Like it had just left itself in.
Then I was talking to this angel.
I was terrified.
I only knew it was real because I can actually remember it.
Then it spoke to me.
Every single word.
It told me, fear not.
How often do you remember that much of a dream? Not often.
And all of my fear just vanished, like the very act of hearing it speak chased away my fear.
I'd had a rough day. It was hard enough to even fall asleep. Then an angel drops in on my dreams and tells me to not be afraid.
It called me highly favored.
Don't be afraid.
Me, highly favored by God.
A messenger of doom is visiting my dreams and I'm supposed to just not be afraid?
Then this angel tells me I am to be with child.
My betrothed is with child. We've only met a handful of times. I've never even touched her, and she tells me this morning that she's with child? You're trying to get to sleep with that in your head? Then an angel interrupts my dreams and tells me to not be afraid?
How?
How is a person supposed to react to that kind of news?
I didn't know what to say. I didn't know what to feel.
I felt numb for a moment.
But the angel told me that this child is to be the Son of God.
Unbelievable. That's the only word I could use. It was the only word that seemed to fit.
But how?
How?
Who am I, a simple girl, about to be married? My life has barely begun. How am I to be the one to carry the Messiah? I'm no one. Yet here's this angel standing in my doorway, calling me highly favored and saying I'm to be the mother to God's Son. It's not that I don't believe it. It can't happen, but why me?
I've lived my life according to the law as closely as possible. I've gone to temple every time I was supposed to, been a fair businessman. So why has this happened to me? And then she tells me the baby is the Son of God?
How will I tell Joseph?
But then this angel telling me not to be afraid, that she truly is carrying the Messiah.
He's a good man.
How can I raise the Son of God? What if I mess up? This shouldn't be put on me. It isn't fair. No man can be righteous enough to raise God's Son.
How will he react?
I wanted to grab that angel by his glowing collar and demand some answers.
So many unknowns.
But when he said that, don't be afraid.
But the angel said to not be afraid.
And it was like all of those fears just melted. And I thought about Mary, how she must feel. She's probably terrified. Then to have to break this news to me, whom she hardly knows, she's just a girl. and she's had this news thrust upon her.
I can only pray that God speaks to him as he did to me. I've only met Joseph a few times, but he's a good man. I like him. And this is a lot to ask of your future husband.
This is a lot to ask of anyone, much less an unwed girl. Then to make the trip to Bethlehem and back for the census? I can't imagine what's going on in her mind.
The Lord has promised that this will be for his glory.
The angel said that this child will deliver us all. I have to trust this. If Mary can do this, so can I.
He would make a great father.
After all, I'll have to admit I like her, which is important in a marriage.
And his name?
We're to call him?
Jesus.
God with us.
The Lord saves.
Emmanuel.
Son of the Most High.
Lord.
Father.
I can only trust that this is of you.
I know you are with me when I am afraid.
Forgive my anger.
Bless your servant.
Walk beside me.
Don't let me falter.
Take away this fear.
You have a plan.
Even though I don't understand.
And it is perfect.
So come.
Oh, come.
Emmanuel.
And I will rejoice.
I will rejoice.
Next, we have a special treat. Byron and Don Hom will favor us with a musical number.
God's morning, church. Happy Sabbath. We're both a little nervous, so please bear with us. I spoke with God a few years ago, and he told me, well, on this day, we're giving out beauty and voice. I said, oh, good. I'm in line for one or the other. And Jesus came to me and said, oops, Dad made a mistake. You got neither. That's just to break the ice a little bit. We're going to do Silent Night.
Test. Follow the star to a place unexpected. Would you believe, after all we've projected, a child in a manger? Lowly and small, weakest of all, unlikeliest hero, wrapped in his mother's shawl, just a child. Is this what we've waited for? 'Cause how many kings step down from their thrones? How many lords have abandoned their homes? How many greats have become the least? How many gods have poured out their hearts? Romance a world that is torn all apart. How many fathers gave up their sons for me? Bringing our gifts for the newborn Savior, all that we have, whether costly or meek, because we believe. We believe gold for his honor, and frankincense for his pleasure, and myrrh for the cross he'll suffer. Do you believe? Is this who we've waited for? 'Cause how many kings stepped down from their thrones? How many lords have abandoned their homes? How many greats have become the least? How many gods have poured out their hearts? Romance a world that is torn all apart. How many fathers gave up their sons for me? Only one did that for me. All for me. All for me. All for me. All for you. How many kings stepped down from their thrones? How many lords have abandoned their homes? How many greats have become the least for me? Only one did that for me. All for me. All for you.
Preparing for our final reading, and this is called Joy to the World, Christ Has Come, and it's a redo because I really like this. It's so joyful. It reminds us of the miraculous birth and the precious gift of our Son, of God's Son, Jesus Christ. There's a part for you to participate in, and there's a and when it's time for you, I'll kind of point out to you, and your part will be Joy to the World, Christ Has Come. We want to say that with feeling. Okay, so we're going to get started here in just 1 second. All right, we got our readers. Okay, all right.
Christmas, a time to celebrate the gift of God's one and only Son.
A time to relive the miraculous story that would change the world forever.
The arrival of our long-expected Savior was here.
Let men and heavenly host rejoice. Joy to the world, Christ has come.
The breath of heaven filled the earth.
Emmanuel, God with us, born into a stable.
Born both Son of David and Son of God, the King of Kings now dwelt among us.
His kingdom would know no end. His love would reign forever. Joy
to the world! Christ has come!
We could not comprehend his ways, our wonderful counselor.
The sinless shepherd who would perform miracles.
And give freely the bread of life and living water.
We would hunger and thirst no more.
Joy to the world! Christ has come.
Christmas, a time to celebrate the arrival of the Messiah, the Anointed One.
A time to honor the day Jesus entered our messy world, to cleanse it from all sin and shame.
To be the spotless lamb, to redeem us from death.
To be the giver of eternal life, the greatest gift we could ever receive.
Joy to the world! Christ has come!
He is the Alpha and Omega.
The first and the last.
The beginning and the end.
God, we thank you for Jesus. We thank you for this season of celebration, of salvation's arrival.
Joy to the world! Christ has come!
Lord, we will go and tell the story of Christmas.
We will share the gift of your love with others.
For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given. And the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord.
We will sing loudly the carols of Christ's birth.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
O come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests. Joy to the world! Christ has come!
Please stand as you're able for our closing hymn, number 125.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ. What fields and floods, what hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy. Curses.
verse is found.
Heavenly Father, you gave us joy when you sent your Son. We feel joy every day that we commune with you. We ask that you help spread this joy as we go forth today. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Amen. Amen.